These dinner rolls are what baby Hawaiian dinner rolls dream about being
when they'll grow up.
Okay, so you want to step up your dinner rolls games. You've come to the right place. My name is Anna, welcome back to my kitchen. Don't miss out on any of my delicious recipes, my gorgeous face, or my humbleness. Subscribe to the channel and hit hard that notification bell. I'm gonna tell you a little secret for great dinner rolls. Butter, a lot of butter. In love, of course. Definitely not a regular dinner roll, so flaky, buttery, pillowy, impressive by both look and taste. So let's roll with the recipe, shall we? The first part is easy, we're gonna make the dough. Start by combining 4 cups of bread flour, the stronger the better, 2 tablespoons of sugar, 1 teaspoon of salt, 1 teaspoon of yeast, 1.5 cups of milk, and 7 tablespoons of tears from any French person, also known as butter. If you have one of these big boys, great. If you don't, no worries, because machines don't cook food. People cook food. I'm gonna suffer along with you and knead the dough by hand. Kneading is not mandatory, but it will improve the gluten structure of the dough and yield a more flexible dough that is easier to roll and laminate in the next step. It's your choice, but I like doing it since it helps with my anger issues. You like that? You like that, bitch? Huh? We'll knead for about 5 to 10 minutes until the dough passes the window test, stretching the dough enough for light to go through it without tearing the dough. Okay, that's pretty good. Cover the dough and let rise at room temp for 30 minutes. Then we're gonna punch it down like it owes us money and start the layering, aka lamination process. Since these rolls are a mix between regular bread and croissants, kind of like an elevated roll and a downgraded croissant, I guess. On a clean table using a rolling pin or a wine bottle, depending what's closer to you, we are going to roll the dough to 30 centimeters, aka 12 inches squares, folded into turrets like a letter, the kind that Napoleon used to send to his lovers. Wrap the dough and chill it in the freezer for 30 minutes. We're gonna repeat the layering creation process 2 more times by rolling, followed by 30 minutes of freezing. This process creates a total of 27 layers in our dough that will result in flaky croissant-like rolls. The freezing step is very important. Don't even think about skipping it. If you do, I'm gonna look for you, I'm gonna find you and feed you proper rolls. Freezing ensures that the layers we worked so much for will stay separated and won't merge into each other. After the final freezing step, we're gonna do one final roll until the dough is 1/2 inch thick. Using a very sharp knife, cut into 1.5 inches square pillows. Please do clean cuts, don't drag the knife back and forth, otherwise the edges will stick to each other and the cute rolls won't rise properly. Just take a few seconds to admire those gorgeous rolls, almost as gorgeous as me. Let the rolls proof at room temperature for about 1 hour or until almost double in thickness. That's almost 1 inch or 2.5 centimeters Russian precision. Crown the rolls with a golden egg wash crown on top, that is 1 egg yolk beaten with a pinch of sugar. Let me flex with some sprinkled truffle salt on top also. And in the hell chamber they go at 375 Fahrenheit, also known as 190.556 Celsius for 10 minutes or until puffed, pillowy, golden brown like this. I cannot imagine a dish that wouldn't deserve this as bread pairing. You can eat them with funky cheese and cherry jam for those French vibes as is, or for those cold fall nights, you can even use them as a pillow. I know I will. Alright guys, and that's a wrap. We've rolled out the red carpet for the baddest dinner rolls in the game. I'm not gonna lie, these are a little bit more labor intensive than the regular ones, but I think they are worth it, because when you bring this buttery pillowy goodness on the table, one thing will be on all people's minds. She's better than me. Anyways, thank you so much for watching. If you've enjoyed spending time with me, subscribe to the channel. Teach that you... What the fuck happened? I ate too many rolls apparently, and the chair is trying to take his revenge on me. Teach that YouTube algorithm who's boss and like and comment on the video. And until next time, remember, life is hard, get used to it.